What's going on, gamers? Today, we are going to go over how to trim a Minecraft world. Before we get started, don't forget to like, subscribe, and click that notification bell to stay up to date on all future videos. Hosting a Minecraft server with a large map can be tons of fun in-game. But if there's ever a time when that world needs to be downloaded, it can turn into a long and tedious process if the files are too large because of the amount of time that it would take. Trimming your world will shrink the file size, allowing you to easily transfer the map to your computer. In normal circumstances, this can be hard since you manually have to delete files or use an external program. But this is solved with our panel trimming feature, which will remove unnecessary region files to save space. Let's go over how to use this tool. Before you start, you'll need to review important information so that you don't lose crucial map progress. Our system uses MCA Selector to trim Minecraft worlds, which is safe to use, but you should still make sure you understand its chunk filter conditions, like the inhabited time setting. This controls how the trimming process works, since this is the parameter to know which chunks to remove. The setting is based on the total amount of game ticks that the player spent in the region. For example, 1 second equals 20 ticks. The more you increase those ticks, the more potential there is for loss of your world progress, so be sure to keep that in mind before starting. Head towards your Apex panel and stop the server, and near the bottom left of the page, click on Trim World. Once you do that, you'll be asked to confirm the world name, and afterwards, you can edit the inhabited time field parameter that controls how the trim works. After confirming the fields, press Trim World to start the process. The world will start its trim, and you can view its progress by pressing OK in the next prompt, or by heading into the console tab. When it's done, you'll see the Done returned OK message in the script. Now that that's completed, you can head back to the main panel page and restart the server to confirm the changes. Now let's go over some common issues. If your buildings were deleted, it might have been caused by tweaking the inhabited time value to an unreasonable amount. For example, if you configured it to be 72,000 ticks, the script would delete chunks that had players in it for less than or equal to an hour, which is a really long time. Make sure you're only using low values for the setting to protect your important progress. If you ever take it too far, you can always restore the world using our guide, which will revert the changes if this happens to you. If the script just isn't working, sometimes if the server is already running another script, it will stop the trimming process. Make sure you weren't deleting any files from the FTP panel, generating a new backup, or anything else before you start the trim. And if you do, head to the console to make sure the script completely finishes. When the world is too large from loaded chunks caused by flying around or pre-generating regions, it can take up unnecessary file space. Trimming the world is an easy solution to make the file size smaller, speeding up the process, and our easy-to-use panel allows you to trim your world without any real prior knowledge. Once the files are on your computer, you can download them to use them in a single player or as a backup to save progress, or you can just keep playing games in the trimmed world. That's all for this one, gamers. As always, I hope you have lots of fun.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.